Okay, awesome. All right, so grab those pillows, prop them up underneath your legs. And then if you've got that blanket or maybe you've got another pillow, I'm gonna prop that up underneath us so that our shoulders are the only thing that are on the earth. Well, that aren't on our pillow. So it's kind of like we're just opening up the upper body here. Again, shoulders are about as flat on the earth as they can be. Maybe you adjust a little bit of those pillows or the blankets. And the eyes, again, remain closed here, and we're just filling up our lungs completely and fully, allowing our bodies to arrive in this posture without judgment and without expectations. Even inhales and even exhales. Nice deep breaths, nice slow breaths. And maybe thinking about using the Ujjayi breath, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. Allowing that parasympathetic nervous system to relax the body, relax the mind. About five more breaths here. It's really melting into the earth, allowing it to hold you up. Really just allowing the breath to guide this posture. Feel free to stay where you are or begin to roll onto the right or the left side of your body, just coming off of your block, well, your pillows rather, your props, and just kind of scooching them out of the way. But don't put them too far, because we're going to come into some nice supported spinal twists here. So it can feel nice to grab a pillow and place it in between the knees. And as you tuck the knees in towards the chest, you'll roll onto either the right or the left side, whichever feels more comfortable to start with. And just having that pillow kind of just feels good, right? Evening out the hips here, the spine decompressing as the knees go over to one side. And the arms can come out into a T. And maybe you want to tilt the gaze to the opposite side that the legs are going. And maybe you just close your eyes here. And take about five breaths on this side. And then we'll start to think about taking this on the other side. And as you're ready, you'll begin to bring the knees back through center. And then take it on to the other side. Either closing the eyes or tilting the gaze over the opposite shoulder. And as you're ready, you'll spend a little time as you are or begin transitioning into supported bound angle pose. So we'll prop some pillows up behind our back, starting from the waist all the way to the top of the head. Yeah, so lay down first. If you want to bring the legs out first, just kind of get into this however it feels more comfortable for you. I sometimes feel stretching the legs out first and then laying down, getting the props settled underneath my spine and my head first often feels pretty good. So we'll start there. So the legs and the bottom are on the earth and everything behind the waist and all the way to the shoulders and all the back and the neck are being supported here. So we'll take the feet, palms. We'll take the feet together at the soles and the knees will fan out to either side. And it can also feel comfortable to put some pillows underneath both of the knees here. And then we'll close our eyes, let the arms hang by our sides. Can always feel good to put one hand on the belly and one hand on the heart. Allowing the breath to lift the chest and the exhale to decompress. Opening up the heart. A couple more rounds of inhales and exhales. Slowly we'll start to find our way off of our props, again by folding onto either the right or the left side. And just again moving the postures out of moving the blocks out of your way, but again keeping them close by. So now that we've moved our props, we'll sit nice and tall, legs extended out long in front of us. And if this is already just a little bit uncomfortable for you, it can feel good to put some props underneath the knees here. or even underneath the sits bones, just to sit up a little bit taller. We are going to come into a forward fold here, but we're going to do it with some props. So you get your blankets, you get your pillows, and you're going to stack them on top of your legs. And you get as many as you need. Never too many, right? And we're just going to graciously and gently fold on over, maybe reaching the toes here, but that's not totally necessary. So what's necessary is that you're comfortable and that it feels good and that your hamstrings and your back are not taking any strain here. And if it is, like I said, prop a pillow underneath your bottom, prop a pillow underneath the knees. And then we'll fold on over these legs and we'll let the head rest one cheek to the pillow or blanket. And again, the eyes can be closed here. The arms can even come just down by the legs on either side. Just a very gentle forward fold here. Getting into the hamstrings, but mindfully and with ease. Maybe you start to turn the cheek to the other side. Slowly begin to find our way out of this posture and coming into legs up the wall. So another nice hamstring, but also back releasing posture. So move on those props on over and find a wall. Or if you're in bed already, I envy you and just throw your legs up your headboard. And if you know you prefer to have a block or block a pillow underneath your hips here, let's go for it. So I'm actually gonna grab another one. You're just gonna scooch close to the wall. Now lay down on your side, throw your legs up the wall. You can get those pillows comfortable underneath you, and you get those sits bones as close to the wall as possible. My feet are out of the frame here, but that's okay. They're up against my wall, I promise. And they're relaxed, not too engaged here. The knees can be even slightly bent if the hamstrings are just not feeling it right now. It's always good to put a bend in the knees, protecting the hamstrings. You can never go wrong there. So with that, we'll get as comfortable as we can, maybe propping our head up on a pillow here, if that feels more comfortable for you. Playing with height on the pillows underneath your waist. And the arms can rest wherever feels most comfortable for you. Maybe both hands over your heart. Maybe arms out by your side. And allowing the breath to ebb and flow in and out. Nice deep inhales and nice deep exhales to calm the body, to slow down the mind. This is a great posture. Just send all that blood the opposite direction. You know, we're so used to walking around and standing up or sitting all day in our chairs. It's good to reverse that flow of energy every once in a while, especially before bedtime. Just a great way to decompress not only the spine here, but the legs. They have such an important role. They're constantly holding us up. Gotta make sure to give them the support that they need too, right? Couple more moments here. And then we'll start to think about putting a bend in the left knee. Maybe that left foot comes flat on the wall. We're just going to take a nice and gentle figure four stretch. So we're going to cross the right ankle over the left thigh. And you can straighten out that left leg as much as you need before you put another bend into it and get into a little hip opening in that right leg. We'll keep that right foot flexed here just to protect the knee joint. This is just a nice controlled way to enter into a hip opening. A good variation of a figure four. So you can just slide that leg up, then you can slide the leg down and kind of just play with stretching out and opening up that right hip. And then we'll slowly unravel that right leg. Stretch it out, maybe give the ankles some nice rolls. And then we'll take it on the other side. So we'll bend into that right knee. Cross that left foot over the right thigh. And you get into that figure four. Again, keeping the left foot flexed just to avoid any knee issues. Maybe bending a little bit deeper or coming out of the bend in that right leg just to play with the hip opening of the left leg. Nice deep breaths here. Really trying to get into that outer hip. The hips are such a good place to store, you know, tension and a lot of repressed energies. So it's good to get in there every once in a while and sending deep inhales and deep exhales as you stretch into this hip will really do some wonders for the body and the mind. As you're ready, we'll unravel the legs here, kick them up the wall one more time. And then we'll start to think about coming into our final resting pose, our shavasana. So we'll bend the knees, we'll come on to either the right or the left side here, and we'll find our way onto our backs. So this will be a nice supported shavasana. So get a pillow, grab a blanket. Maybe you're in bed, so get cozy. Grab a pillow for underneath your head, a pillow, or maybe two for underneath your knees. Just a great way to release back tension. And again, maybe you want a blanket to just cover your entire body. That can feel really nice. And we'll find our way onto our back. Letting the knees splay out to either side. The legs are nice and relaxed here. Arms are down by our sides. Shoulders are away from the ears. Together, we'll take a deep inhale through the nose, filling up the belly, the lungs. Open your mouth and empty it all out. Begin to breathe a natural breath here. Start to close the eyes. Allow the body to become still. And we'll practice allowing the mind to become still. And by still, I mean allowing thoughts to arise, acknowledging their presence, but letting them go, holding no attachments, simply just being present and bringing an awareness to your breath. Shavasana. slowly we will begin to bring an awareness back into our bodies, wiggling the toes, maybe wiggling the fingers. Maybe you stay exactly where you are. Eventually, coming onto the right side of your body for fetal position. And again, you can stay in your shavasana and you can end your practice here. You can crawl into bed. I'm slowly just going to close out our practice. Coming onto a comfortable seated position, keeping the eyes closed here. Just bringing the hands to your heart center, maybe one hand over the heart, one hand over the low belly. Together we'll take a deep breath in through the nose and a nice breath out through the mouth. Give ourselves some gratitude for showing up today. Bringing the thumb knuckles to the third eye center. We'll bow to each other as we say namaste. Namaste, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me and allowing me to practice with you. Always a pleasure. Grateful for these moments together. I hope you have a beautiful night's sleep, and I hope to see you at our 8 a.m. class tomorrow morning. 30 minutes of a nice energizing flow to get you through the rest of the week. So as always, if you have any questions, any comments, please reach out. And if you enjoyed the class and took something away from it, please feel free to send a love offering if that's something you're into. They're always welcome and we're always grateful for it. So thank you again, you guys. Have a beautiful night. Thank you. Thanks, Julie. Have a great evening.